Hello, my name is Alex Kogan. I'm a professor of accounting information systems at the Rutgers Business School. And what I would like to talk about today is our joint work with a former student of mine, Chen Ying, who got his doctorate about 2 weeks ago. So this paper is about making audit analytical procedures work better. And audit analytical procedures have had a long, distinguished history. And if you look at the literature, it has almost 50 years of development. It started with basic ratio and trend analysis, and now it extends all the way into actually utilizing very sophisticated regression and time series models. One of the critical issues in audit analytical procedures is to utilize as much information as possible to make them as accurate, as predictive as possible. In some of our previous work a while back, we established that peer information greatly enhances the performance of audit analytical procedures. So if you are auditing company A and you can utilize information about their peer company B and company C in running analytical procedures for company A, then it will lead to better performance. Unfortunately, even industry specialist auditors are constrained as far as contemporaneous peer information is concerned. Even if the same auditor audits, for example, several different banks, auditor for bank A cannot know what the current information of banks B and C is because it is controlled by the code of professional conduct, as well as the conditions in the engagement letters that restrict the usage of non-disclosed yet company information only for the purposes of auditing this particular company in this current period. Therefore, what we focus on in this paper is how to deal with this constraint and still utilize, derive some benefits from the fact that an industry auditor actually does have access to contemporaneous peer information and how it can be used in analytical procedures. We follow a number of different approaches. We propose a generic sharing scheme that can allow, engagement teams to communicate modified information of the current period to the other engagement teams without disclosing confidential information. So, and this modification can be done in a number of different ways. In particular, we investigate the usage of the so-called residuals or differences between the predictions of the models and the actual observations. And we show in this paper that even these residuals can provide some additional information that enhances the performance of analytical procedures. And this performance of analytical procedures is enhanced both in terms of their prediction accuracy as well as in terms of their capabilities of detecting errors or other irregularities when, say, the numbers have been modified and the auditors have to discover these modifications. So we do hope that this kind of research advances can be utilized in practice and can lead to higher quality audits. Thank you.